Artist Toolkit with Guitar Guitar.
Hey guys, this is Nick Johnston hanging out once again in Guitar Guitar, and I'm going to show you some stuff from my Artist Toolkit. I've been asked to kind of demonstrate a little bit of my legato technique, which is something I've been more or less working on developing and constantly maintaining for about 20 years. Quick things to note, I'm left-handed, so a lot of this stuff that I'm going to talk about, or a lot of the stuff maybe you've seen me play, is sort of almost on an unconscious level because it's my dominant hand. There's like little weird muscle twitch kind of things that happen in my playing. And my right hand does a bunch of muting. There's always something going on with, like for example, if I'm playing something where I have like, this hand is kind of on standby to mute everything. For example, if I'm playing this note, let's say I have a D, everything around it is gonna be muted naturally. So that's something just right off the bat. If you're getting strings ringing, I'm using quite a bit of gain too, because why not? It's fun. If you're getting a lot of strings ringing and just external noise and stuff, just remember, it's all about the muting. And I'm gonna show you some of the stuff I've been up to lately. I'm kind of right in the middle of a clinic tour, so I've been going on stage every night and talking about guitar and technique and playing and all that wonderful stuff. And I've started to even notice a few things changing, because this is the first time in about 2.5 years where I've gone up and played live. So I'm noticing my playing has evolved just even getting on stage every night. And one other thing to note is I'm now using this piece of metal here. I'm using a whammy bar, whereas for years and years I used to claw at the bridge like an animal. And I got sick of having bloody knuckles from banging my hand against it. So I figured I'd do the more gentlemanly thing and use a whammy bar. With that being said, let's kind of get into it. So the way I've kind of developed my technique is, you know, it's very left hand dominant. I use what's called hybrid picking. So I'm kind of treating the middle finger as a lot of upstrokes. And I like to do sort of a type of thing where I take a shape or some sort of pattern, and I'm able to plug it into different positions on the neck. So if I learn how to do something, it could be something as simple as this, which is, you know, it's just a pattern, it's just a shape, but I'm able to plug it in all over the place. So that's kind of, you know, Nick Johnston legato 101. But what I've really been getting into lately is sliding into stuff with the bar and trying to connect lines with a lot of chromatics and sort of trying to play very lazily as a lazy player. Trying to connect stuff with that. For example, let's say I was an A minor. What I would maybe do is, see if I did that a little faster. It won't be exactly like that, but the approximation is what counts here. Trying to do stuff like that where I'm connecting a lot of chromatics together. It's almost creating this tension, but it knows where it wants to go. It kind of wants to resolve. And the way I'm looking at the neck there, it's all modal. Like, I'm basically just looking at, which, so it's all kind of modal, but I'm just kind of connecting the dots a little bit. You know, and then if I was to keep going with that, let's say, which is, you know, absurd, especially when I'm tapping up some of these higher notes. But it's really all about getting the momentum, sliding into it, using the bar to kind of swoop the note, almost like cradle the note, and then just use some of these patterns. So let's kind of break some of this stuff down. One thing I love to do is, let's say, take a little bit of the A minor scale. So I'm gonna use the top of that. One thing I like to do is go like this. And then I'll use the pinky finger to kind of bar the note, so I'll get, So again, real slow. If you watch this hand too, you can see what's happening. It's just two picks, a down and an upstroke with a middle finger. If I'd maybe connected that all over the neck. Pretty cool, especially if you're trying to avoid just playing three note per string pick stuff. You get bigger kind of interval jumps, especially if you're skipping strings. Let's say we had that. Or let's see if I can do this here. Stupid, but it's just all about plugging in that pattern to whatever you can think of. If it was all diminished stuff, you know. What's that? Something like that. Just trying to get that bar and that kind of whipping motion with the hand. It's all just developing the hand strength. I mean, none of this is going to happen overnight. This has been decades of practice. And I remember I used to come home from school in high school and I would just take these little ideas, even like, you know, something like this. Basically until it sounded like a raindrop on a tin roof. And then a bigger stretch. Working all those finger groupings, but you know it's really just about how creative can you get with it, how much can you use the key you're in, what chord you're playing over. Like if I'm playing over an A minor again, obviously I know I can do all that. The Joe Satriani stuff, but I could also use, you know, all sorts of different intervals. I could play. So I'd start on the 7 maybe. So now I'm getting a little bit more tension. So I'm like paying attention to the key I'm in, but I can also kind of weave in and out of it a little bit. And this is all sorts of stuff I'm thinking when I'm improvising or playing over chord changes. But I think with any technique, you have to sort of step back from the person you're trying to learn it from or the licks you're trying to learn from and maybe think about what your strengths and weaknesses are. I've tried to learn over the years, you know, parts or ideas from other guitar players. You know, I remember trying to learn the Flying in the Blue Dream, kind of those lines when I was a kid. I could never do them. It's just my brain doesn't work that way. But the intention or the idea of what's kind of going on behind the scenes is really what I was paying attention to. And that's just that left hand strength, developing patterns that work for you, getting your pull-offs actually pulled off, not just taken off. They're not called take-offs, they're called pull-offs. It's a bad joke, sorry. And then connecting them across the neck. So let's do one more. This is what I want you to practice. Here's your homework from this video. Taking a C chord. And here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go, let's follow along. One more time, and watch this hand too. There's very little picking going on. And faster. See, this is one of those ones where it's either played slow or really fast. It doesn't really sound good if it's anything but fast, but it's the double practicing. Okay, up to speed. And you should be able to just get this kind of like did it thing going on. Different key. And if I move that around a bit, let's see if I can do it. Good luck. So what's really cool now is over the pandemic, I sort of had this big idea, this big project where I wanted to essentially unscrew the top of my head and dump everything out into a video series. I created this course called Purpose. It's a beast. It's about 14, 15 hours long, and it kind of covers everything from technique to music business, songwriting, production. We go in the studio and break down Remarkably Human and Wide Eyes and a bunch of stuff I've done. Crazy amount of content. So please check that out, nickjohnstonpurpose.com is where you can see that. But I've been Nick Johnston at Guitar Guitar, and that has been my Artist Toolkit. Thank you guys.